Hi, everyone. My name is Anavi Nahar, and I lead the Azure Load Balancer product group. I'm glad you're watching today as we learn more about Gateway Load Balancer. We announced this at Ignite, and I'm so excited to share more. We'll go into a few details and set you up with ample resources to learn more, given this is a 200-level session. Here's the agenda. I'll give you context on the customer pain points, as well as partner pain points we've heard from our customers and how we solved it. Of course, we'll chat more about the scenarios, as well as you'll hear from our partners. Lastly, I'll talk through key takeaways that I'd like you to take away from this session. With that, let's jump in. You've often heard about NVAs or network virtual appliances. I'll use NVAs and appliances interchangeably. But really, what are NVAs? NVAs are network virtual appliances. They serve a specific network virtualized function. Think of your firewall, your DDoS protection application, your application delivery controller, for example. NVAs also run on Azure virtual machines. And customers love virtual appliances because they're able to do advanced networking capabilities. And they also did this on premises. So it brings that sense of consistency over to the cloud. In addition, customers have built expertise over the years and have teams who are very skilled in specific NVAs as well. And they want to bring that over to the cloud with them. Customers often also have contracts with appliance vendors. What's a few examples of NVAs? Firewalls, intrusion detection protection systems, inline DDoS, IoT applications, and so many more. Now that we know what NVAs are, let's learn about how customers deploy NVAs in Azure. Well, before Gateway Load Balancer, there's three different models. The paired model. In this case, when going from a source to a specific destination, you go through a pair or two NVA appliances specifically. As you can imagine, if there's any issues with the network virtual appliances, the customer's business will suffer as this is a single point of failure, or a SPOF, as we call it. It's also a management overhead because you have to individually manage these devices, and as you scale out, things become a little bit more hard to manage. Another model is the dual LB model. Dual, meaning there's two load balancers, an internal load balancer and an external load balancer. So traffic going from the source to the destination needs to be routed to this. Even from the visual, you can understand that it's a little bit more complex to set up. As a result, troubleshooting is also harder, and errors or human errors are very expensive. There's another set of customers that kind of just say, hey, I'm going to do it myself. It's too complicated. I will do it with my own tools and my own scripts. This is great, but it adds up pretty quickly when it comes to cost. Now, we've learned about all of the challenges that customers face today with NVAs and how to set them up in Azure. So we got together and decided to solve this problem to prevent such challenges for our customers collectively. I'm glad to introduce you to Azure Gateway Load Balancer. Gateway Load Balancer makes appliance integration into Azure super easy. So what is a Gateway Load Balancer? A Gateway Load Balancer brings together the key functionality of a gateway and a load balancer. You can think of Gateway Load Balancer as a single entry and exit point for traffic. And that's the gateway piece of it, coupled with the load balancer functionality. Things like high scale, auto scale out at distribution that you need for your packets, as well as health checks. So we'll only send traffic to appliances in the backend that are healthy. In addition, Gateway Load Balancer will ensure flow symmetry. What this means is that packets will take the same route. This is key for specific NVAs, especially stateful firewalls, that function on flow symmetry primarily. All right, let's walk through the flow of what would happen. So let's say I have my application, as you see over there, and it's chained to Gateway Load Balancer. Traffic coming in from the internet is unfiltered or untrusted. And so when it first hits my standard load balancer, which is chained to the Gateway Load Balancer, traffic will go to the Gateway LB. Now the Gateway LB encapsulates the traffic using VXLAN, or Virtual Extensible LAN. This is a protocol that enables network overlays in a physical and virtual network. Once traffic hits the Gateway Load Balancer, Gateway Load Balancer with its health probe ensures traffic goes to the appropriate healthy appliance in the backend. Then traffic is sent to the appliance and whatever application it's running, whether that's a firewall, inline DDoS, even packet filtering, then occurs. Once that advanced filtering is completed, The traffic is then rerouted to the application, and then it's sent to your end application instance in the backend pool. As you can see, the source and the destination have no idea that the gateway load balancer is even in the path. So it's transparent to both the source and the destination, making it super lightweight. Let's delve a little bit deeper into the gateway load balancer benefits. Gateway load balancer is super easy to set up. This is my personal favorite benefit of it. Of course, I'm a little bit biased. But all you need is a simple click to chain or reference your application to a gateway load balancer frontend. Since you're able to use appliances that you are already familiar with and like, customers can leverage existing skill sets that they've built with these appliances with Gateway Load Balancer. Since it's fully native and leveraging our software-defined networking stack, you can take advantage of the full scale of Microsoft. In addition, it's completely transparent. There's no actual invasive changes that are needed to your network when you insert the Gateway Load Balancer. It's truly taking the concept of service chaining or that bump in the wire technology and bringing it to life in the cloud. You need no manual or error-prone updates, making troubleshooting a lot easier. Another benefit is scale. With VMSS and auto-scale, we'll automatically take care of scaling in or scaling out with respect to the nature of your traffic. Gateway Load Balancer also enhances your appliance's availability. Not only that, the Gateway Load Balancer can be referenced across virtual networks and across regions. This is super beneficial for deployments at scale because then you no longer have to worry about these boundaries with respect to virtual networks or even regions. Now that we learned about the benefits of Gateway Load Balancer, let's delve into the scenarios. Before we delve into the scenarios, let's learn about where network virtual appliances or NVAs are inserted in the cloud. Usually, customers insert them north-south, which is from internet to VNet or VNet to internet. And this is not just return traffic. It's even traffic that's starting from your virtual network or being sourced from your virtual network, as well as east-west, from one VNet to another, for example. So let's take the scenario of north-south traffic inspection. So in this case, I have my two applications as an end customer, as well as I've chained them to my gateway load balancer in the provider subscription that you see. So any traffic coming in from an untrusted source will first hit my standard load balancer's front end. Since this is chained to my gateway load balancer, all of the traffic will transparently be routed to a healthy instance in the back end of the gateway LB. The gateway LB will carry forward the VXLAN encapsulation, as I mentioned, and the appliance provider would decapsulate. What this means is that the provider is able to see the full traffic as it was originally intended. As a result, traffic will go from the same instance back to the application, maintaining flow symmetry. Now, this concept or this routing pattern that I just walked you through has a plethora of applications, whether that's in the firewall, whether that's in packet inspection, inline DDoS, port mirroring, or even advanced analytics and port mirroring technologies. Some of our customers are even using it for visualization. What's more, with Gateway Load Balancer, you can even build your own custom appliance. Let's say your favorite appliance is not doing what you need it to, but you've built your own custom appliance for your unique needs. As a result, with Gateway Load Balancer, you can bring your own appliance into Azure and have exactly the bump in the wire technology that you need. What this means is any traffic going from any source to any destination goes first through your appliance, and so you don't have to worry about things like management at all. As you know, Microsoft is a partner-focused company. We win together with our partners. So for the launch of Gateway LB, we've partnered with more than 10 partners and continue to expand. We have partners ranging from network security, firewalls, traffic inspection, traffic visualization, and so many more. Gateway Load Balancer not only is beneficial for our customers, but it's also beneficial for our partners. First and foremost, the simplification of appliance deployments. Gone are the days where you need a long, detailed deployment guide that you need to study in order to figure out how to deploy in the cloud. Since this is cloud native, we have the benefits of our software-defined networking stack, making this highly available and highly scalable. Partners are able to build appliances as they really need it to or intend it to as a managed service. Gateway Load Balancer removes friction from building in the cloud for our partners. They don't have to worry about scale. They don't have to worry about availability. They can just focus on their key area of expertise, which is building amazing appliances. Now, instead of me telling you how beneficial it is, why don't I let one of our partners, Laura from Trend Micro, tell you all about it instead?
Trend Micro is really excited to be a launch partner for Azure Gateway Load Balancer with our cloud network security solution, Trend Micro Cloud One Network Security. This solution provides IPS and virtual patching to customers and is all about the easy deployment experience. So this diagram here shows a common customer environment or deployment model. The customer hosts web servers behind a public load balancer, but due to misconfiguration or running a vulnerable web server, these web servers become victims and exposed to the internet and can be easily attacked. And now with the Azure Gateway Load Balancer and service chaining integration, it's even easier for our customers to deploy this on Azure. So you can go right to the marketplace, find Trend Micro Cloud One Network Security. We want to deploy the network security scale set VM with Gateway Load Balancer and get started with the configurations. What's really great is that a lot of these stick with the defaults. Your virtual network information, NAT information is all going to come in automatically. So then you'll go through some validations, make sure everything works exactly as expected. Great, green light, validation passed, and then we'll deploy. Deployment doesn't take too long, but we've sped it up with a little bit of movie magic just to show you here. And deployment is complete. The last step is to do the single-click Azure deployment of service chaining. And that's really important because it helps our Cloud One network security appliance keep that transparent inspection capability to protect both inbound and outbound traffic. What's really great about this is even an existing environment can connect to the Gateway Load Balancer without any redeployment, keeping it super simple. So anyhow, once the public load balancer is chained to Gateway Load Balancer, both the inbound and outbound traffic is protected by Cloud One Network Security. And we're going to run the same Metasploit to attack the web server, but you're going to see it fails. And that's because the attacker fails to create an interpreter session to the vulnerable web server, even if the vulnerability still exists because of our virtual patching capabilities. And you'll see here in the log files where we were able to stop this. So this is how Azure Gateway Load Balancer with service chaining makes it even easier for our shared customers to deploy Cloud One Network Security. Thanks.
Thanks, Laura. That's great to see the difference and the power of Gateway LB and Trend Micro's cloud security solution. If you're a partner and you would like to integrate with Gateway Load Balancer, we'd love to hear from you. Of course, your appliance needs to support VXLAN technology, as I mentioned previously, but feel free to reach out to GWLB, which is the shorthand for Gateway Load Balancer, so gwlbpartners@microsoft.com. We're super excited to hear from you, and I hope you'll reach out. All right, let's wrap up. With the Gateway SKU, we now have three SKUs of the Azure Load Balancer portfolio. Basic, as the name suggests, for primitive or basic applications at small scale. Standard, for highly performant and ultra-low latency applications that you're trying to build in the cloud, taking the benefits of zone redundancy and resiliency at both a regional and global scale. And finally, we learned deeply about Gateway Load Balancer, catered specifically for network virtual appliance insertion, making it transparent and easy to manage for a variety of scenarios. To summarize, Gateway Load Balancer is a single entry and exit point for all your traffic. With Gateway Load Balancer, a fully managed and distributed service, inserting appliances into the network path is super easy, simple. It's also completely transparent and enables your appliances to be highly available. Gateway Load Balancer is available in all Azure regions, government cloud regions, as well as China cloud regions. You can get started with using Gateway Load Balancer through the Azure portal, CLI, or your favorite client. To learn more about Gateway Load Balancer, go to aka.ms/gatewaylb. We're excited to hear from you about all the different and new scenarios you're going to build with Gateway LB. Thanks so much for listening.